He played just 6 seasons in Orange and Black, but Danny Briere was beloved by the Flyers fan base. A feisty player who was fearless around the net despite his smaller stature, Briere was one of the best clutch performers of his generation. He owns the Flyers franchise record for points in a postseason with 30 in 2010, becoming only the 28th player in NHL history to reach that plateau, and just the 3rd this century. But the Flyers needed to part ways with Briere last summer, albeit amicably. So it was a given that he'd be welcomed back with open arms when he returned to Philadelphia for the first time as a member of the Montreal Canadiens.
Like I said, when this past summer, this is still home for me, and it will be even after my career. So, Philadelphia will always have a special place in my heart.
This is that story. This is the Flyers flight plan.
It's a little weird walking in this morning, taking visitors' entrance instead of what I've been used to for the past 6 years. But it's also a good feeling coming back here, seeing a lot of familiar faces and people that I've had a lot of good times with the past few years.
Briere and the Canadiens were in town early, waiting for the Flyers to return home from their longest road trip of the season. As game day arrived, Flyers coach Craig Berube challenged his team to play with more physicality and desperation in a very important game, leaning heavily on his second line, centered by Sean Couturier.
Death chip! Get your glove down. No. Get your glove down.
Come on. Okay, sorry. Sorry, man.
Good. I'm coming in.
I didn't think you were that small.
Is it even a penalty?
I think it was an elbow right to the head. They might call it now.
Down.
What did I do? Can't hit? Seriously, what can I do? High stick?
Flyers penalty number 14, Sean Couturier, 2 minutes for high sticking, 5 minutes and 4 seconds.
3, 2, 1, go.
Hey! Hey, hey, hey!
Oh, we're gonna go 4 back. Normal. Or you wanna do it still?
Well, it's up to you.
Because Raffle doesn't really know what to do then. He's gonna stretch me in. Shenner's gonna cut in the middle. I'm gonna stay wide here. Reader's gonna be on your just normal.
While Couturier's line was superb in shutting down the speedy Habs, it was a new line that Berube put together that started paying immediate dividends as Michael Raffle's promotion to top line left wing sparked the offense.
Voracek trying to spin it in front. The Raffle for the shot. He scores! And he has his second NHL goal. The Flyers a 1-0 lead.
The change even saw a better performance from Claude Giroux, who, like Raffle, was the recipient of a great pass from Jake Voracek and put it home for what would be the game-winning goal.
Jin picks his way back into the Montreal end. Left wing, Voracek out in front. Giroux with a shot, he scores!
The Flyers clamped down from there, frustrating the Canadiens to the point that upon the conclusion of the game, some emotions boiled over.
Takes it to the wall, makes it off the glass, out to center ice, that'll do it. And now we got a scrum. Mason ends up with Gallagher. Gallagher now taking punches from Reed. And all of a sudden it gets wild and crazy as the horn sounds. Flyers have won the hockey game 2-1. But Gallagher ended up all tangled up with Mason.